Tattooing, a practice in the Pacific that only decades ago seemed very male-dominated, has taken a turn. More and more Pacific women are looking to the art form as an expression of culture.
It's sort of like a visual statement of pride, of where I'm from, and something that connects you to a distant homeland. You know, we may not be raised in the islands, but we still feel like a cultural and spiritual connection.
Tattoo artist Tyla of Samoan heritage works at Karanga Inc., a female-owned and operated tattoo studio in Auckland. She's finding a growing number of Polynesian women are seeking contemporary tatau.
The hand is becoming more popular, whereas going back maybe 5 years ago, it was like, no, don't ever put anything on your hand, you know, because what if you go for a job interview and they see you have a tattoo on your hand? So attitudes like that are changing. It's interesting, you know, women will come in and they still, whether they're 20 or 30, oh, I can't show my mum. So there's definitely, like, just a generation back that's still not open to tattooing.
One Kiwi Samoan going under the needle is Nikki Samu. The tatau she received during our visit today is inspired by her heritage and events in her life.
I wanted to share my story, and I think the best way, you know, as a Samoan woman to share my story is by telling it in this way, using our patterns and our symbols.
Only a few hours later, Tyler's job is done.
I love it. I almost wish that it was in a place in my body that I could see it more often, like I'm having to, you know, turn around and look in a mirror, but I'm just amazed at Tyler's work and how she was so perfectly able to take just what I had said to her and to present it in a way that was something that I had sort of imagined in my mind.
Rosanna Raymond has been in the creative industry for 25 years and says even though it's malu in a modern form, it continues to be deep.
We must remind ourselves of that even though there's a contemporary form and a contemporary rendition, without the meanings and these deep kaupapa behind them, they will become just as commercial and stereotypical as the very thing that we're trying to, you know, step away from.
Raised as Samoan and Māori and adorned with tatau, including some by the late Paulo Suluape, Rosanna says it's a way for Pacific women to speak to the world.
It's my message to the Pākehā world that, yeah, I'm not prepared to, you know, conform to your standards of beauty. This is a tāhua. This is, you know, this is my bling. This is my diamonds and my pearls. This is my platinum. And when you're in a room with all these tatau bodies, the talk is amazing, it's so loud, it's beautiful, and yeah, I love it.